Sorry. Thank you very much indeed.
That's very good.
Fine. What?
Nothing. We really have to go, do we?
Oh, yes. I think so, don't you?
Evening, Mr. Foltill. Evening, Mrs. Parsons. Everything ship shape.
As you see, Mr. Rigg.
Plenty of soft drinks, too.
As you see, Mr. Rigg.
We should get a really big turnout tonight. My parents always rally to the call.
I hadn't realised your parents were coming tonight.
What? Oh, yes, quite right, of course, Mr. Foltill. Our parents. Yes, they won't be backward in coming forward.
Can I ask you something, Mr. Rigg?
Fire away, Mr. Foltill.
Why are we Mr. Rigg and Mrs. Parsons and Mr. Foltill tonight?
Sorry?
Not Godfrey and Estelle and Fred.
We're on show. On parade. Parents.
Ah.
But they're not here yet, Godfrey. Are you just getting into the vein?
That's one of the marvellous things about you, Estelle. No one's going to get delusions of grandeur with you around. Appreciate that, Estelle. Fine. Good head on that, Fred. Well, work to do.
Pratt.
On parade, Mr. Foltill.
And only 4.5 hours to go.
Good evening, good evening. Everything all right?
So far.
You're with a band, are you?
I am the band, son. Wandering hands to you.
Oh, pleased to meet you, Mr. Rigg, the headmaster.
So?
I understood you'd be in costume.
Have no fear, we travel in mufti. That way our entrance makes greater impact. Nicht wahr?
Oh, right. I've not had the good fortune to catch your act before.
Well, you'll be catching it tonight, then, won't you?
Oh, yes, yes. There's a good deal of comic patter, I hear.
Aye, now and then.
Nothing blue, I trust. It's not me, you understand. I'm as broad-minded as the next chappy. But we're C of E here, and Vicar said he might be looking in. Vulgarity, yes. Smut, no. Right? Fine.
Ah, oh, my little schoolboy.
Arseholes.
Bloody hum.
Brain rot bad, is it?
Terminal.
What is it, actually, that?
Oh, you know, the usual. You know that actress Di, the one who can cry real tears? She's due for more tears, and I can't think of any more trauma she hasn't had before.
Ah. She goes home to see her father.
Who?
Oh, the nurse in the serial. I'm helping you. She goes home, and there he is. She's got something very important to tell him, and he just sits there, staring into space. Suddenly, she realizes it's happened at last. Terminal brain rot. Her dad's a vegetable. One of the living dead.
She doesn't move. She doesn't speak. Slowly, the big tears roll down her cheeks.
Right.
That's very good. Only one set, too.
You're not going to do it.
Why not?
Oh, Christ. Bloody hell.
Did you actually want anything?
Just you owe me £2.50.
Owe you the 50?
Yeah, okay.
Disco, is it?
Yeah. They're actually letting us play for half an hour tonight.
A gig?
Sort of.
That's great.
Fairly great. I thought you were going out tonight.
We are. Bavarian night at the Parent Teachers Association of St. Peter's Primary School. How about that?
Oh, sounds terrible.
I can't do it. I just get worse.
I know the feeling. Do something else for a bit and then come back to it.
Going out and meet anywhere.
Where to, Jackie's?
No, Lucy Forest.
Never heard of her.
Oh, Dad, she just lives up the road. I'm staying there tonight. I told you.
Oh.
I'm Florence. And this is Carl. All right?
I remember. It just slipped my mind. Will you take a key, Carl?
Yeah, OK.
Mum doesn't want to go to that thing at school.
I know.
Going to make her?
Mm-hmm.
Why?
Well, it might be fun. And if it's not, it might be material.
Oh, God, you just use everything, don't you? Little girls with flutes wafting up and down stairs.
Don't you like it?
No, I don't.
I'm sorry. Give us a cuddle.
No, not in the mood. Go on, tap.
Blimey, Bavarian.
Come on, Robert, let's have you.
Well, I thought it was Thursday. Come on.
Give us a kiss, then.
I thought you were going up the youth club.
I'm waiting for Ginny. He's supposed to be calling for me. Tell her to give me my T-shirt, Dad.
Give him his T-shirt.
What's the matter? Are we disturbing you?
No, I've finished now.
Oh, tell him to give me a kiss, then.
For Christ's sake, give her a kiss.
Can't stand anybody having any fun without you, can you?
Look, I'll go.
Oh, don't be...
That's a really nice bit of silk screening.
Well, this is true.
I meant to ask you, could I borrow that other one you did?
What, tonight?
Yeah, thought so.
Oh, poser. Yeah, all right, I'll leave it out.
What's the matter?
Nothing's the matter.
Look, we don't have to go if you really can't face it.
Yes, we do. Because you promised Jim and Arlene.
I could phone them, put them off, they wouldn't mind.
Yes, they would. Of course they would.
Yeah. Still.
You know what you're doing.
I'm not doing anything.
You're trying to get me to say, it's all right, forget it, it's fine, we'll have a wonderful time, then I'm sorry I was a bit grumpy, all that, aren't you?
Well, I honestly don't see why you're being like this. You like Jim and Arlene, we always have a nice time with them. I mean, there's a bar, we can drink. You've been known to take a drink. We'll be doing our bit for the minibus fund. You like to do your bit. We'll be positive parents. We'll get a glow. Anyway, we've never been to a Bavarian night. It might turn out to be just our thing.
It'll be awful.
Yeah, I expect so.
But it might be material, eh?
Nothing really bad can ever happen to a writer.
Bully for you, old chap. What it was... Actually, I wanted to go out myself tonight.
Oh. With,
Yes.
But you didn't say. You should have said.
You don't exactly make it easy, Joe.
There are other nights.
I know.
Just going round to Ginny's. Good evening, sir. What would you like tonight?
I just came to call for Chinny.
Lê Vinci, youth club. 今晚我係你時做工，我過嚟個妹妹讀書嗰邊。
But I told you, Dad. Look, I'll be back before the busy time, and so you can save us, child.
冇好耐啊嘛，知唔知？10:30仲係快啲先放工。
I've got to be back early. My dad's got some meeting up at the school.
All right.
Goodbye, sir. Thank you very much.
Ciao.
Just a little thought I had.
Very original.
Yes. I thought so.
Wouldn't life be simple if they were all like that?
Oh, they will be, Mr. Foleshill. We're winning, you know.
It wasn't that I was scared or anything. Just very, very acutely embarrassed, I suppose. It's the roles that life forces you into. Parent, husband, all that.
Well, that's nice.
Being a parent is about my favourite thing. Sometimes I think it's the only thing I really like now.
No, that's not it. Being those things, that's all right. It's acting the role.
Arlene, your hair is like liquid copper.
Just washed it, haven't I? Got to be clean for Bavarian night.
Why do you comb it? It doesn't need combing.
I like combing it. Jim likes to comb it too, don't you, Jim?
I must confess I do, yes.
I like it when someone else combs it. Do you want to go?
Yeah. Thanks very much.
Life, you see, forces one into these roles.
I forced him into it, he means. I told him he had to do something.
So I thought, well, okay, you know, this is it and all that. My wife's dignity and honor have been impugned. So I walked up to him and said, look here. And he said, what? An unpromising opening. So I said, I understand that you've, just call my wife an old scumbag. He said, do you know what she called me? I said, I'm not interested in hearing about that. The point is this, that, well, if you do anything like that again, I'm going to have your effing hide.
Really?
The trouble was I couldn't seem to get the right degree of feeling into it. I felt he was embarrassed too. We both seemed to have run out of things to say. So I went back into the house. We actually seem to get on quite well together now.
Well, there you are.
He's all right, really.
In his way.
It is extraordinary, isn't it? I mean, did you really have any idea at all what it was going to be like? All that actually buying a house and living in a place and having neighbours? And having kids and seeing them go to school. And that quite extraordinary way one's life seems to be closing down and opening up at the same time. I mean, when our kids were little, it used to be the big moment of the day, going down to the school gate and waiting for them with all the other mums. All that variety of sizes and shapes and incomes. And there we'd be, all with our separate secret lives all buttoned up in our Macintoshes, and yet at the same time all part of the same thing because of what we shared. I really found it enormously exhilarating, that sharing, all in it together.
Yeah, well...
And then they'd come out, the kids, all falling over themselves and dropping the drawings and, you know, doing all the things they do, talking to themselves and singing. And we'd gather them up and take them off and hear about all their stuff. You can't bloody well beat it, can you? I mean, I actually tried it the other day. It was pissing down about 4 o'clock, and I thought, I'll go down the comprehensive and give Carl a lift. So I took the car down, and there they all were, coming out. And I still got a buzz out of it. He wasn't a bit grateful in point of fact. When I saw him, he was walking along, soaked to the skin, in the middle of some argument with a bunch of girls. And when he got in the car, he said, Christ, that's all I bloody need. Rich little boy gets driven home in Daddy's Rover. I didn't care. I was having a ball. It's bloody great, as far as I'm concerned, that he's got friends who work in slaughterhouses and a Chinese takeaway. I never knew anyone like that when I was at school. It works. State education works. It's the whole thing of having kids and seeing them grow and change. It is, actually, a sort of miracle that we all share, isn't it? I've embarrassed myself.
You look nice.
Yeah. Well, if we're actually going, I suppose we better actually go.
Gentlemen, parents of St. Peter's Primary School, good evening.
Good evening.
I won't keep you long. We know why we're here, to enjoy ourselves and to show how much we care about the children. And it's really very heartwarming to see you here tonight in such numbers. Now, I expect you'll all have noticed our little friends here. Don't they make you want to go, ah? Well, they're with us tonight, ladies and gentlemen, for two reasons. Partly to remind anyone who still needs reminding that that's the official school uniform.
Very good.
Optional at the moment, but I'm glad to say that at the last count, over 85% of children are wearing it. Now, how about that for support? And of course, ladies and gentlemen, of course, it will be compulsory from September.
Shame!
No. I know we've all got the school's best interests at heart, which brings me to the second reason why our little friends are with us tonight, just to remind us that they are what it's all about. Yeah. Our youngsters. Our youngsters. We want the very best for them, don't we?
Yeah.
And by golly, with our new PTA, we're getting it. We've already got the video cassette machine. We're well on the way to the minibus. And by the end of next term, and you all know how near to my heart this is, we will be the only primary school in Loxley with its very own trampoline. Now, how about that? And now, ladies and gentlemen, without more ado, I will leave you in the very capable hands of Wandering Hands and the Heinkels.
Ovation. We thought you were dead, now we see you're only half dead. Keep your eye on that one, Otto. Right, ladies and gentlemen, we are German band. We have travelled far to be with you tonight.
Yeah, all the way from Huddersfield.
Stunk off. Right, ladies and gentlemen, on the drums, my second in command, Otto. On my right, on the typewriter, Heinrich! On my left, Manuel. I'm the prisoner of war. First we'll let him blaze and I think we shoot him.
Thank you.
Stop! Right, now for your orders. You see our banner here? We teach you a little German. Very easy. Ein Prosit. That means a toast. Good health. Cheers. Down's the arch and up's the jacksy. Right after me. Ein Prosit.
Ein Prosit.
Ein Prosit. Ein Prosit.
Ein Prosit.
Ah, very nice. Think we are ready now for the big one. Jägermuttlichkeit. In your tone, that is good fellowship. After me,
Jägermuttlichkeit.
All together, Jägermuttlichkeit.
Jägermuttlichkeit.
Terrible. But never mind, it'll get worse. Right, now we put it all together. First we show you, then we all try. A Bavarian drinking, begin. Ein Prosit. Now it's your turn. As you see, we have ways of making you drink. Right, now when I say I'm Prosit, everybody rise. I'm Prosit! Wandering Hands is waiting. Wandering Hands is still waiting. Bavarian drinking. Right, now we play, you drink, y'all have a good time. Anytime you want a toast, you get up and shout, Ein Prosit. Thank you. Hi, side, try, fear.
Don't you think it's wonderful?
Amazing, yes. Wonderful, no. Look, we could actually just go home and have a few drinks there. What do you say, Jim?
Oh, I don't know. Now we've sort of come.
I want to see what happens. I can't believe this. Arlene wants to see what happens, don't you, Arlene?
Oh, I always want to see what happens. All right.
Anyway, we can't go now. There's supposed to be German sausages later. We don't want to miss the sausages.
And I understand that after the interval, we're going to let you beat up a few Jews.
Christ, Jim.
Sorry, yes, I suppose that was in terrible taste. I was trying for a note of savage irony.
Suppose I told you that I'm half Jewish.
Oh, my God.
She's not Jim. She's always doing that to people. You mustn't do it to Jim. He's our friend. Look, you made him go all red.
Serve him right.
I'll get some more drinks. 2 pints, vodka and tonic and a half, right? It'll all get better when we've abused the temple of our bodies with a little alcohol.
Large scotch, then.
That's my brave girl. We've come through a lot together, you know. We can get through this.
I'm
you tonight.
Fine, thanks. Night off, is it?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Good evening, sir. Thanks, Fred.
Hello, Fred. It's 2 pints, vodka and tonic, and a large scotch.
Right.
Enjoying yourself.
I'm just about managing to keep my ecstasy under control.
Joe Pine, isn't it?
That's it.
Tim Pine. We're just down the road from you.
Are you?
Last 6 months. Your daughter's at our place tonight.
Oh, God, yes. Sorry, you're Lucy's dad.
That's it. We're at number 14. As a matter of fact, we've almost run into each other a dozen or so times. Literally, when you back out your car.
BMW.
Sorry?
The car I drive.
Blue BMW.
Ah, yeah, your horn works very well.
Fortunately.
Nice road, though. Nice place to live.
Well, it could be.
Oh, it is. You haven't had time to appreciate it. Off license at one end, chippy and takeaway at the other. What more could anyone ask?
Don't you think that entails certain drawbacks?
Oh, well, it gets a bit noisy at chucking out, sir.
Well, I'd put it a good deal stronger than that. I'd like to get together, have a chat about that sometime.
Yeah. All right, if you like.
Later this evening, if we get a chance.
Super.
Oh, it's hard to know what to wear to a do like this.
Maybe jack boots would have been the thing.
Oh, come on. It's not as bad as all that.
Oh, no, no, don't get me wrong. I think it's amazing. I think it's wonderful.
It's a good turnout. I've got a lot of time for this chap, Rig. He's put a lot of life into the school, Joe. It's all right if I call you Joe, is it?
Okay.
Yeah, it takes guts. You need guts today in a job like his.
I think you've scored.
Excuse me, sir.
Please, call me Jim.
Excuse me, Jim. Could you please tell me when are we to meet the teachers?
Well, I think there's quite a few here. Who did you want?
I am not sure. You see, I cannot stay very long, sir. Do you think the meeting will begin soon?
I hate to tell you this, Mr. Chin, but I think this is it.
I'm sorry.
This is, how shall I put it? I'm afraid this is all it's going to be.
This is a meeting of parents and teachers.
It's a sort of social evening to enjoy ourselves.
Ah, yes. I see. And then we discuss the progress of the children's work.
Well, no, I don't.
Ah, yes. Thank you very much.
Life really is very extraordinary, isn't it?
Oh, God, whenever he's pissed, he wants to start talking about the meaning of life.
But looking round here, aren't you struck by the extraordinariness of it all? All of us here manufacturing so much goodwill and gemütlichkeit and all that All that grim determination to enjoy ourselves. The way we meekly allow ourselves to be brainwashed by that bunch of semi-musical fascists up there. It really is a tribute to the resilience of the human soul, isn't it? I mean, and all this alcohol we're consuming in the cause of getting on well with each other, it really goes to prove what basically well-intentioned people we all are. Don't you think?
I can remember. I think I can remember. I think it really happened. Just sitting around in people's rooms drinking coffee, actually talking. Just soberly sort of talking about the meaning of life. Far into the night. I think I can remember that. I think it really happened. Do you remember that sort of thing, Alice?
Of course I remember that sort of thing. I remember a lot of that sort of thing. Then. We're different now, though. We are not the same.
I've never talked about the meaning of life in my life.
Of course not. You don't need to talk about the meaning of life, because you embody the meaning of life.
What the hell do you mean, she embodies the meaning of life?
Some of us talk about it, some of us embody it, that's all. Nothing very deep.
What the hell makes you think that Arlene embodies the meaning of life any more than the rest of us do? I mean, speak for yourself if you think you don't embody the meaning of life. I happen to think that I embody just as much meaning of life as anybody else here. I mean, if all you want to say is that you fancy Arlene, well, why don't you just tell her and stop dragging the rest of us into it and making a bloody seminar out of it, all right? Is that all right with you too?
Oh, anything goes with me, Ducks.
Fine. Thank you. Well, I'm off to the loo then.
Your wife is tremendously articulate, isn't she?
She is.
Your wife ain't.
No, well, still.
Look at Mr. Chin. He thinks we're all balmy.
No, I'm sure he doesn't. You ever talk about the meaning of life, Mr. Chin?
No, not very much.
That's because he knows what it is.
Oh, no. No.
He does. He knows what it is, and he's not going to tell us. Come on. Be a sport.
Well, I think a man must work very hard to make his success in life. Do you think the headmaster will allow us to inspect our children's work this evening? I think we should all be very interested to see it, huh?
Thing was a glass of water.
That's an unusual request. Just the plain water.
Got a bit of a headache.
I appreciated your response to our leader's address.
Oh, that. Well, I thought a bit of disaffection was indicated. Won't do any good, of course.
I should say not. Most of them love him. Some of the kids seem to quite like him. He's a runaway bloody success, Mrs. Pike, and a lesson in how to get on. Parsons looking at me like that because I'm being highly unprofessional. But I've had a few drinks and I feel highly unprofessional, and it's been a tiring evening.
It's tiring in there, too.
To be frank, I like the other sort of parents' meetings, where you sit in quiet corners and discuss long division and that. I may be oversensitive, but I like parents when they're sober, anxious, and a little bit overawed. Not singing their heads off and puking in the infant's lavatory. There you are, you see. That damns me as a figure from a bygone era.
Oh, well.
Yes, sir, what can I do for you?
Mr. Foldhill, Mrs. Parsons, how's it going?
I didn't think they could drink so much.
Well, I told you my parents will always rise to the challenge. Keep up the good work. Don't dash off. Mrs. Pike, isn't it? Yes, I've been hoping for a quick word.
Oh, yes?
Just wanted to say, quite understand your feeling on the uniform question. Two points of view about everything. And I'm proud we've got the sort of atmosphere here where a person needn't feel afraid to voice a minority opinion. And may I say, if all our kiddies were like your little girl, there wouldn't be the need for a uniform. Of course they're not. They
need something extra that's going to make them feel part of the school and proud of the school and keep them up to the mark and give them a bit of pride in themselves. It's all a question of standards, ultimately, you see, and as much as we'd like to, we can't make exceptions. Knew you'd understand.
Small bit of lemon, please, Mrs. Parsons. Yes.
I should have thought that if you can't give the kiddies those things without sticking them in those bizarre outfits of yours, I should have thought it was round about time to pack up, wouldn't you?
Well, as I said, two opinions about everything, and I'd be happy to argue it out with you on another occasion.
Good, I'll make an appointment. Look, please don't dash off just yet. It was you that asked for this little chat. Just wanted to say how interesting we find your newsletters. I expect you often wonder if they actually get read.
Well, yes, one does wonder. I do feel it's important to make the parents feel part of the school.
Why are you so interested in corporal punishment?
I'm not interested in corporal punishment.
Well, you do rather keep returning to the subject. Don't you think it's just a little morbid?
Mrs. Pike, corporal punishment in this school is a very rare occurrence indeed. A last resort. And as a last resort, it has its place. Now, you may not realise it, Mrs. Pike, but we do have some very serious problems to contend with here.
Yes, I'm sure you have. It's funny that they banned it at the comprehensive, where they must have much more serious problems to contend with. Surely you should be able to cope with the problems raised by little children of under 12 without resorting to the threat of violence.
I am not interested in what they do in other schools. This is my school, and I run it as I see fit. And let me tell you, I have never met the child that I can't handle.
Well, I'm not actually keen on your handling my daughter in any way at all. Still less threatening to hit her with a stick. She comes to school to be educated, not to be bullied and assaulted.
Now you're being ridiculous. I wasn't born yesterday, you know. I've seen this sort of thing before. Anything, any excuse to criticise and undermine the work that we are doing for your children. But you have a very clear option. If you don't like the way I run my school, you can withdraw your child. I'm very glad to say there's a good long list of parents eager to get their children into this school because of the very things that you are sneering at. Now, I hoped we could have a nice, friendly chat like two grown-up people, but I see we can't.
Well, thank you for being frank, Mr. Rigg. All over now. Excuse me.
Must have gone home.
Oh, no. Just having a little chat with Mr. Rigg. I'm quite enjoying myself. Can I have a soup of your ale?
Go on, just like nectar.
We want the sausages. We want the sausages. We want the sausages. We want the sausages. We want the sausages.
Sausages, and they haven't come through yet. You did arrange for 10 o'clock.
Oh, bugger the sausages! I'm sorry.
Oh, don't mind me, Mr. Rigg.
These bloody middle-class parents, who that do get up my nose? You can work yourself blue in the face for them, go out of your way to accommodate them, but it's no use. They just have to carve and criticise and try to make a fool out of you. Ooh, I felt like... I'm ashamed to tell you what I felt like.
Giving her a good hiding.
Yeah, somebody should have done it, I don't mind saying so. Gonna make me sick. Always had the wrong way. Always had the best of everything. She should have been brought up in our house. My dad had her sorted. I'm sorry, this isn't with me, I know. Well, that's my evening spoilt for a start.
But what about the sausages?
All right, stand still now. What the hell do you think you're doing in there?
I'm sorry, sir, I thought...
Yes, I'd like to know what you thought!
I thought that it might be permitted for parents to inspect the work of the children.
You're a parent?
Yes, sir.
Ah, I see.
I am Mr. Chin, sir.
Oh, yes, Mr. Chin. Well, you see, Mr. Chin, this is a social evening, Mr. Chin, to raise funds for the minibus, and there's going to be a tombola later on. And it's a very good chance for people to get to know one another. And really, if you want to inspect your child's work and discuss his progress, you ought really to make an appointment. We'd be very happy to see you at any time. My door is always open. Aren't you enjoying the Bavarian evening?
I beg your pardon?
Look,
Oh, bloody hell. Carry on if you like. I don't care.
Thank you very much.
Interesting than any of the other people I know. No offence, Jim, but it is honesty time, isn't it? A bit early. Well, special circumstances. Do you like your work, Jim?
Honestly?
Of course, honestly.
Oh, of course I don't like my work. I mean, it's quite interesting, and one's definitely overpaid for what one does out. The people are all right, you know, as people go, but I never actually wake up wanting to go there.
Never?
Never. Come to think of it, I never want to go out in the evening either.
Not even with us?
Even with you.
Even here?
Especially here.
I like your honesty, Jim.
Thanks, Joe.
It all seems so unfair, doesn't it? The way they separate us from our children. Talk about bloody apartheid. Not content with locking them off in schools all day, they have to arrange it so they were separated in the evenings. Fragmenting the generation. Each decade its own ghetto. Why do we have to play it being Bavarian? Why are they doomed to pogo their nights away in the disco?
Ours are actually only 4 and 6.
So?
Too young to get into the disco.
That's exactly the sort of thing I mean. To play with each other's teddies while you sit here yearning for them. We're all so isolated, Jim. Scattered. Like the dead bright stars in the universe.
Side of it to consider. I mean, we all had parents too.
I've still got them.
I mean, I bet they didn't think it was all going to turn out like this. People's loins quickened to produce all this.
Gosh!
I was trying to articulate a serious thought here. Do you know, my mother once confided to me that I was conceived under a Morrison table in the middle of an air raid.
You're older than you look, Sonny Jim.
My point being that there must have been such hope there. Some sort of picture of an ideal future. Do you see what I mean? And multiply it out. Look. Look at everyone. I mean, if all our mothers could see us now, at this moment, as we are now, would they think it was worth all the danger and discomfort of giving birth? All the bother of bringing us up? And look at all that parenting we're doing now. I mean, if they're all gonna grow up like this, well, looked at like that, it all hardly seems worth the bother, does it?
That's exactly what Yeats said.
Oh, well, for once in my life, I had an original thought. Oh, well.
Among school children. That's the poem. Mind you, he did put it differently.
I cannot bear it when people start talking about poetry. Do you fancy a dance, Joe?
Oh, can we dance?
Looks like it.
I won't have to slap my knees or anything.
I should say that's up to you.
Right.
Oh, chestnut tree, great rooted blossomer, are you the leaf, the flower, or the bone? Oh, body swayed to music, oh, brightening glance, how can you know the dancer from the dance? I used to love Yeats so much, you know.
Excellent dancer, Arlene. What's funny?
This isn't dancing. Do you know what I'd like to do now?
What?
I'd like to take my brains out and run them under a cold shower.
Yeah. I feel a bit befuddled.
All right.
What?
Sorry.
All right, what?
Look, what did you say just then?
I think I said I felt a bit befuddled.
Oh. I thought you said, I feel like a bit of a fumble.
Oh. All right.
All right.
I've had a few, but I wouldn't ask you if I hadn't. But you hear all sorts of things, you know.
Oh, yes, sir.
I haven't offended you, have I? Have I offended you? I wouldn't offend you for the world.
No, I'm not offended.
Oh, that's good. Then you can tell me, then. Man to man, like. Hey, they're the same, aren't they? It's all a load of gobbles, isn't it? That's it, isn't it?
I think I must go soon, you know.
Hey, they're just the same, aren't they? They're just the same as English girls. That's what you're telling me, isn't it?
There is one small difference.
No.
Yes. We think they smell much nicer.
It's all right, you know. It's not the girls' cloakroom.
Well, if it's the boys, you shouldn't be here.
It's the infants. Look at those little low pegs. They don't segregate the sexes in the infants.
That's, good to know. Look, I'm not so sure this is a good idea anyway.
What?
lovely and cool down here. Oh, look. Someone's left their jumper behind. Can't read the name, it's too dark. Have you got your name on your things? Big trouble if you haven't. You know, Jim's been really weird lately. He only seems to like it in peculiar places. On the stairs. In the garage. He's really ingenious, I will say that for him. Do you think that's weird, Joe?
No, that's not too weird. Actually, with us, it's more been different people.
Yes. I thought that's how it might be. Choose your pick, Joe.
Very well, friends. Thank you, your lovely face. And now, a little treat for our very own prisoner of war, little Jose from Holomolinos there. Give him a big hand. To remind Jose of his homeland. Una Paloma Blanca.
I'll go ahead. Better, really.
You sure? You okay?
Of course I am. Silly.
Good of you to join us, Joe. Just a little informal get-together. Thought we'd get away from that infernal bloody noise for a bit, right?
Nice idea.
Right, know everyone, do you, Joe?
Well, by sight, yeah. Hello.
Now, some of us here are a bit worried about the way things are developing.
Oh, I think it's quite a jolly do.
No, not this evening. We're talking about what seems to be happening in this part of town. Joe lives in Arbor Road, like me.
Oh, say no more, then.
Now, if I say just two words, coping stones, Joe Pike will know what I'm talking about. When I bought my house, Arbor Road was described to me by the agents as one of the premier residential roads in this town. One of the premier residential roads. Now, there's people living in Arbor Road now who are afraid to walk down the street after 10 o'clock at night. Am I right, Joe?
Well, it gets a bit noisy, I suppose.
Oh, come on, admit it. It's a battlefield. They've declared war against civilized values. Let's not fiddle about. Trees vandalized, aerials ripped off cars, urinating and vomiting in our front gardens. And when it's a case of getting up every Saturday morning to find your coping stones in the gutter again, it's time to stand up and be counted. Yes, Joe?
Before you go any further, could I ask just one question?
Yes, of course, Joe.
What's a coping stone?
In here. Well, what have you been doing? Have you been having a dance?
You've been gone an awfully long time.
Have I? I went for a sort of walk.
Where's Joe?
He's talking to some men. They're in a classroom down the corridor. Don't know what it is. Some men's thing. You ought to go and have a look. What's the matter?
I think you ought to know you've got your blouse done up on all the wrong buttons.
Oh, shucks! Oh, well.
All we're saying is it's time these hooligans saw for themselves that people don't like what they're doing and that they are prepared to do something about it. Now, I was hoping that you'd be with us, Joe, as a friend and neighbour.
We won't keep you up too late.
When?
Well, tonight. It is Friday.
Eh?
Show 'em what's what like.
Go down Arbor Road and beat the shit out of our own kids on the way home from the disco. That's the plan, is it?
Yeah. I'm so bloody stupid, man. Of course we're not talking about our own kids.
Well, whose bloody kids are they? There must be somebody.
Oh, don't talk bloody rubbish, man.
My son's down there.
All right, Milton. Fine, Joe. Thanks for giving us your time. No, one sort of thing. No hard feelings, eh? We're all parents, aren't we? That's the boy.
I've just had a very disturbing experience.
What was it, Joe? How awful.
Well, I'm glad you asked me that, I'll tell you.
Did you know there's a gang of fascist parents going out roaming the streets looking for teenage children and mugging them?
Honestly?
Yes, I just heard it with my own ears. Where's Alice?
She went home, Joe. I think she got tired of waiting for you.
Oh, dear.
All part of life's rich tapestry.
Been a bit heavy here. Silly, really.
Joe, could I have a little word?
Yes, of course.
We'll just be a second.
What was it? It'll be all right. She quite often goes off without me. She likes it. I just give it a bit of time and then she's fine.
Look, I realize that to you, my relationship with Arlene must seem a lackadaisical sort of business. I realize that to the outside, it must appear, how shall I put it, absolutely minor.
That's very well put. I admire it, actually.
Well, it's not like that, you see. It's not like that at all. Oh, dear, this is very difficult and embarrassing.
I'm an old friend.
That's part of it, you see. What I wanted to say was that I am, well, for better and worse, deeply and passionately in love with Arlene. And obsessively jealous. Homicidally jealous. And, well, if you and she ever slope off again and do whatever it was you did.
Get him home like this!
It's not my fault!
How could you say it's my fault?
Of course it's not your fault, Godfrey! Look, Fred's
phoning for an ambulance.
That's never a coma.
Yes, it is. Don't you tell me what's a coma and what's not a coma.
2 points, please.
It's worse than that, Mr. Pike! It's anarchy!
Turning and turning in the widening gyre, the falcon cannot hear the falconer.
What?
Come on, Mr. Ring!
No! No!
I'm sorry, we're cleaned out. They've drunk us dry.
I'm sorry, sir.
No more drink.
Ah, I did not come here to buy a drink. No harm done.
Good.
Mr. Forcehill, sir, I find that you are my daughter's teacher. She's called Su Chin.
Yes, I am.
I know you're very busy, sir, and I know now this is a social occasion, but I promised my wife that I would talk to Su's teacher.
Mr. Chin, you mean you came here tonight to this madhouse to talk about your daughter's schoolwork?
I'm sorry, it was a mistake.
Mr. Chin, I'm delighted. Your daughter Sue is a little treasure. She's one of the ones that makes it all worthwhile. She's a clever girl, very quick. She loves to learn things. She's neat. She's polite. She's a bit shy, but she's got plenty of friends. She laughs at my jokes, Mr. Chin. I'm very fond of her. And I'll tell you where she shows up well. Science. It makes them think a lot, and some of them don't like that. But she does. You see, I've taken up Nuffield science, and by golly, it's interesting what it shows up. But you don't want me to go on about Nuffield science.
I am very interested to hear about it, sir.
You are? Come on, then. Let's get out of here and leave all this. I'll take you down to the science room, and I'll show you what she's doing.
Things fall apart. The center cannot hold. Mere anarchy is loosed upon the world. The blood-dimmed tide is loosed, and everywhere the ceremony of innocence is drowned. The best lack all conviction, while the worst are full of passionate intensity.
Thank you.
Fair night, though. What do you think, Enoch?
Average, very average.
Right, well, I'm off then. Night all.
Hey, hey, hey. Spanish barbecue tomorrow. You got it? You turn up as sodding Tarzan on our white bloody floor, would you understand me?
Right then.
Well, next Friday, then? Yeah.
Oh, you live, Chinny.
Blind rock star plays on.
Ah.
Christ, what happened?
Nothing. We just finished early.
But what's the matter with your eye, Chinny?
It's a polo mint. They were chucking polo mints at us. The audience. It's all right. It's a mark of respect. He just had to get one in the eye.
Oh. You didn't get any trouble on the way home?
No. It's only a couple of hundred yards, Dad.
Hey, what time is it?
It's about 11:15.
Christ, look, I've got to go. Dad's going to kill me if I'm late.
Hello.
Hello.
Look,
doesn't matter.
What would you like?
You're not starting again now, are you?
I won't be long. I just wanted to get a few things down while I remember them.
Things about tonight, you mean?
Yeah.
Look, I can't stop you, but I would much rather you didn't.
Why not?
Doesn't it ever occur to you that you've raided our life so often you've left it in tatters?
I don't feel like that about it.
You don't feel like anything about it because you're not really in it anymore. You just process everything. You don't actually notice any of us anymore. Everything is just material now. You don't really care about anything, do you?
I do care about things.
I'll go. Hello? I thought it might be you. No, we haven't been back long. Well, it wasn't all that dreadful. It was quite funny, really. I'll tell you about it. Yes, I will, won't I? Oh, dear. Oh, poor old you. Oh, dear. Oh, yes, I suppose I will, won't I?
Yes, really. Because I can't. Sorry about that. Weren't you in the middle of saying something? What's the matter?
It's just that particular tone of voice you use. It's just that tone of voice that I find difficult to...
difficult to cope with.
What tone of voice?
When you're talking to him on the phone.
Oh.
It's all right. I'm not complaining. I'm not asking for anything. I'm just explaining. You see, I sometimes hear it when you're talking to the kids, even now and then with the cats. But you never use it or anything like it when you're talking to me.
Oh. I didn't know. I'm sorry.
There's no need to apologize.
I just meant that I'll try and be more careful about it in future.
I was just sitting here trying to remember what you used to sound like when you talked to me. You know, a long time ago. I can't properly remember that time at all, you know. I can't remember what we were like then. I can only remember what we're like now.
I can remember what we were like then.
Can you?
I can remember very clearly. I can remember sitting at a lecture near the back when you were sitting about three rows in front of me. We'd only just met. I was still a bit scared of you. I can even remember the lecture. It was Emsley on Yeats.
Oh, I remember Emsley.
He used to call him Willie Yeats, the fascist beast.
I can remember sitting there staring at you, willing you to turn round. I could only see a bit of your face, just about a quarter of it. And I remember thinking how lean and gaunt and uncared for, and not actually very well you looked. And you were wearing an oily-looking navy blue jumper and that dreadful old mac you had that came down to your ankles. You were just sitting there glaring at Emsley. I always admired the way you never took notes. And I was just putting my whole being into willing you to turn round so that I could see your bright eyes.
And did I turn round?
Don't you remember?
I remember the Yeats. Did I?
Yes, you did.
That's extraordinary, remembering that.
Well, I make you a present of it.
It couldn't have stayed like that.
No, I suppose not. Not that we gave it much chance.
Carl and Florence really are something, though.
Oh, yeah.
We have got them.
For a while.
It's a sobering thought, isn't it? And after a certain time, you realize things are going to go on more or less the same, barring accidents, until you die.
I don't believe that's true. Not as far as I'm concerned.
No. Well, keep me posted, won't you?
It'll all be material.
Excuse me, mate, you got a light? Cheers, mate. Night.